3, 2, 1.
Skipping the intro today, no time to waste. So technically this is part 2. If you didn't see my last video about optimized media, I will link that in the card above and in the description below. Like we talked about last time, clicking optimized media results in your footage being transcoded into ProRes files that show great quality while editing and are easy to edit, but are really large file sizes. If you have a fast computer and storage, this may work for you. My go-to method, and I suggest going this route if you have a slower computer and or you want to keep your file size down, is to choose to transcode your footage to ProRes proxy files. I've found that choosing ProRes proxy at 50% offers really solid performance while editing compared to just editing native camera footage, and it'll save you a lot more space when compared to the large uncompressed ProRes media files. The trade-off here is image quality while editing, so you may notice that your footage doesn't look as good as it should, but remember, these are essentially copies of your original footage. Once you switch to original or optimized footage, which you should do before you export, you'll notice that your quality is still there. If your computer is still struggling with ProRes proxy at 50%, transcode to a lower quality ProRes proxy. Once again, this will result in playback image quality being worse, but your file sizes will be even smaller and you'll be able to edit with ease.